Hallelujah, hallelujah. Welcome to 7 Minutes with Jesus. I'm Minister Tommy Turner from the Church Within International Ministries. This will be our opening for various ministers that will come forth. So this morning, I'm going to share one of our ministers with you so that you may get a glance at what we do here at the Church Within for 7 Minutes with Jesus. Let us open in prayer. Father God, we thank you for your word. We thank you for an opportunity. We pray that the words of our mouth and the meditations of our heart be acceptable in thy sight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good afternoon. Every speaker has spoken on process, obedience, and loving and understanding. My scripture is 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. My scripture is, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9. When I read that, I'm saying, my grace is sufficient. God said, my grace is sufficient for you. For my power is made perfect in weakness. And we as Christians, sometimes we get weak. Amen. Sometimes when we don't understand how, when you go reach your hand out to help others, they just cut it off in the midst. But Jesus Christ said, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Sometimes I get weak, but then I have to realize I visit my little closet, and that's my bathroom. And when I visit my little closet, Papa decided that he's going to wrap his arms around me because he know that in my weakness, his grace is what? Sufficient. So when I decided that, oh Lord, I can't take no more, I can't go no more, I'm tired, but he said, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. In weakness. Weakness. What do weakness mean? Weakness that you can't move anymore. Weakness is that you help people and you still can't move anymore. Weakness is that you supply their needs when they're homeless, but they still slap you in your face. And I'm not talking about anybody. I'm talking about my family. How they, you help. You try to help. And then all of a sudden, it's like, you're supposed to do it. I'm not supposed to do anything because God said, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. In weakness. I'm weak, people. I'm weak. Sometimes it's hard to get out of my bed. And then Papa comes into my bed and say, you know you got to get up. You know you need to go to the job. You know that I have supplied this job for you so you can vote. Go there. And then you know what? You can witness to others. And see, that's the best part. I can witness to people and they don't know I'm witnessing to them. But then they'll come back and say, thank you. Thank you for that word. My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Sometimes it's good to be in weakness. Because you know why it's good to be in weakness? Because Papa said, okay, I got you. I got your back. I take care of you. I will supply all of your needs. And I tell you, he does supply all the needs. Because on Saturday last night, he supplied my needs for a bill that I didn't know that I, and it was the amount that I needed. Because he said, my grace is sufficient for you. For my power is made perfect in weakness. Church, all we got to do is, his grace is sufficient for us. And then I read this at work. It said, be sure to taste your words before you spit them out. be sure to taste your words before you spit them out. Because last night, my nephew Darius gave me a hot pepper. I didn't taste my words, but I had to move around in order to spit them out. But that's Proverbs 16 and 24. Be sure to taste your words before you spit them out. In other words, think before you speak. Amen.
Amen. Till we see you again face to face in Jesus' name.